How are buyer's agents going to get paid from here forward? Extinguish those fears right now. Here's how. Stay tuned. The commission settlement, the commission lawsuits, and the settlement that just came to be, I mean, it's practically old news. It was in the paper and the news media almost every day, and now you're not hearing much about it anymore after the NAR settlement. But the problem is the NAR settlement seems to be confusing. It's opened up a whole host of additional questions. It kind of feels unsettled. There's a lot of moving parts still. And so people are asking questions. Well, how am I going to get paid if I'm a buyer's agent and I work for a buyer? What's my fee going to be? How do I share my value, and what is my value? And when is any of this stuff going to get settled? Well, one way that I'm really getting through it, and two books that are really helping me right now, one, and I'm going to talk about it today, is called The Full Fee Agent. It's a book by Chris Voss, who was the FBI's lead kidnap negotiator. And he wrote that book, Never Split the Difference. And Steve Scholl, who was a Mike Ferry, NFL football player, then Mike Ferry coach, they write this book called The Full Fee Agent. And it has been incredibly helpful for me as I'm working through some of these commission things. In the book, they make four main points. We're going to get through those today. I really recommend you read this. Point number one. It's more about trust than value. So with the settlement, the first big thing that I heard was, hey, you're going to need to share your value proposition with your buyers in order for them to be comfortable signing the agreement and hiring you for a fee to help them through the process of buying a home. And what Scholl and Voss say is it's not about value or your value proposition. Those are important, but unfortunately, they tend to commoditize realtors. What you need to do is you need to get into a trust relationship with people. And the best way to do that, they use a term or a phrase called tactical empathy. And then they go deep into tactical empathy, talking about how you can utilize that or how you can exhibit that when working with your customers. And then they go into a section inside of tactical empathy about understanding human behavior, because in order to utilize tactical empathy and build trust, one needs to understand human behavior. So for example, the best predictor of how someone's going to act in the future is how they've acted in the past in a very similar or same situation. And so if you understand human behavior through the questions that you ask, you'll be able to utilize tactical empathy to get into a trust relationship. It's not as much about value, but trust. Second main point they make in the book is, are you the favorite or the fool? In any consultation, in any interview that you go in and meet with a buyer or a seller, you are either the favorite or the fool. Every seller, every buyer has someone they're leaning toward, or when they go in, they get some context to compare everyone else against. So someone comes into the interview process as the favorite, and your goal is to ask five questions that they lay out in the book that can help you determine at this point, am I the favorite, or am I tending to be the favorite, or am I one of the fools? And if you are not the favorite, you need to work to become the favorite, or just give up on the appointment, is what they say. And in fact, they don't even go to appointments unless they know, or recommend that their coaching clients don't even go to appointments unless they already know they're the favorite. Big discussion on favorite or fool. I think that's really good. Third, know your role. You're an advisor, not a solver of all their problems. Too often as a realtor, we think that our job is to solve problems. Our job is really to help people understand or identify problems and then look at different options. But people make the decisions themselves and people solve their own problems. And people want to do that. They want to be led, but ultimately they want to feel like it's their decision and their solution. Last thing is they talk about how to get hired for the full fee. They say, first, change your mindset. You're no longer going to that listing appointment to interview for a job. You're now going to see if you would be a good fit for them and whether you should offer your time or whether it doesn't make sense for you or them to do that. And then in that last section of the book, they have a great set at pages 163 to 169 and 171, a great section, 6-7 pages on the commission dispute. That they don't address it directly. They wrote the book before it, but it really gives you some good scripts around commission and how to build trust as well as share value to get clients on board. Isn't that what we all want? Great book. It's really helped me through some of this uncertainty related to this buyer's agent commission stuff. I recommend you check it out. I think it'll help you too.